Electric motors are used as drives in many industrial applications. Such motors are operated by pressing push buttons. Control operation of motors include starting, stopping, reversing the direction of rotation, speed control, sequence operation of a number of motors, etc. The control of motors is achieved with the help of a control circuit. The control circuit is designed by using a number of components. Some of those components used in control circuit are here. The main component is the conductor. The conductor has a coil and a number of contacts. Some contacts are normally open and some contacts are normally closed. When the conductor is given supply, the normally open contacts will close and normally closed contacts will open. A conductor can be represented by a simple diagram. In this diagram, this is an electromagnet. This represents the coil of the conductor. When this is energized, this piece, which is movable, will be attracted towards this piece. This movable piece is placed in this position with the help of two springs. This is one spring, this is another spring. Now on this moving part, the contacts are placed. Now here you have one contact, this is another contact, this is the third contact. In addition to these three main contacts, we can have auxiliary contacts, small contacts. This is a normally open contact. You can have also a closed contact. This is normally close contact. Now this contactor can be represented symbolically like this. This is the coil and on its armature number of contacts. So this is the main, three main contacts, and you can have auxiliary contacts, small contacts like this. So this is the conductor coil, you give supply here, and these are the main contacts which close when the conductor coil is energized. These are the auxiliary contacts. This is normally open, this is normally closed. Now the other components is a cartridge fuse, which is used for protecting the motor against short circuit. This is an overload relay, thermal overload relay. There are three bimetallic strips which are connected in series with the main lines, and when overloaded, these bimetallic strips will get heated up and open a contact, which in turn will de-energize the conductor coil. Now these are the timers. This is called a time delay relay, where you have the coil which is to be energized, but its contact will close or open after some time delay, which can be set by this knob. This is the electronic type time delay relay. This is a pneumatic type time delay relay. It has also a coil and a set of contacts. This is a synchronous timer, same purpose, you know, you have the supply to its coil and the contact will operate after some time. Now you have here this limit switch. It's a mechanical type which is used for limited operation of a motor. These are signal lamps. These are push button control stations. These are the push buttons. And now inside this box, one of the push buttons is fitted. Now a push button, if you'll see, has got four terminals here. Two of the terminals make a NO contact and the two terminals make an NC contact. There are two contacts, one normally open and one normally closed. Depending on the requirement, we can use any of the contacts or both the contacts. Now using these components, we'll make a simple contactor control circuit. And you know, as you know, a three-phase induction motor can be started by giving three-phase supply directly to its terminal. This can be done by energizing a contactor. That means when the contactor coil will be getting supply, it will give supply to the motor terminals through closing of its contacts. Now here we have the bus bars, where from you get the supply. This is the contactor. Now when you give supply to this contactor, these three contacts will close and supply will be available across the motor terminals. Now suppose the contactor coil is rated for 400 volts, we will connect 400 volt across it. But through a push button. This is the on push button. Now when you press this push button, this coil gets energized and its contact will close and supply will be available to the motor terminals. That means as long as the pressure on this push button is kept, the motor will continue to rotate. The control of the motor is achieved by keeping pressure on this push button. So such operation is called inching operation. In many industrial applications, you will see the motor is operated, that is started or stopped manually by pressing a push button by hand. But if we want to have a situation where once we press the push button, this motor should continue to rotate, then we can use one of the auxiliary contacts, normally open auxiliary contacts of this contactor connected across this on push button. That means these two terminals should get connected across this on push button. Now if that is done, once the pressure on the push button is released, the contactor coil will continue to get supply through the contact of the same contactor. Because once this is pressed, this is energized and this contact closes. Now once this contact closes, the pressure on this push button can be released by keeping supply on to the conductor circuit. So this contact is being used as a hold-on contact to the conductor coil. That means supply is hold-on through the contact of the same conductor. Now, to switch off the motor, we'll have to connect one push button with normally closed contact in series with the coil. This is off push button. Now, in case we want to stop the motor, we'll press this push button. The circuit will be broken. The conductor contacts will return to their original position and the motor stops. Now, if you want to have a thermal overload protection, we connect thermal overload relay in series with the lines. And this thermal overload relay will have a contact which is connected in series with the control circuit. Now, when the motor is overloaded, these bimetallic strips will bend and thereby open this contact. If this contact is open, this coil gets de-energized. These contacts will open and the motor will stop. Now, for short circuit protection, we must connect three fuses, cartridge fuses, in the three lines. And in case of short circuit, they will blow off and the motor will stop. Diagram for a DOL starter. DOL starter. For a three-phase induction motor. In this circuit, you will see there are two distinct circuits. This is supply coming straight away from the bus bar to the motor. This is called the power circuit. And the conductor coil circuit is called the control circuit. Here, both the circuits have been drawn together, but they can be drawn separately. While designing a motor control circuit normally, we draw the control circuit and then we develop the total circuit. We will now see the representation of the power circuit and the control circuit separately for a DOL starter. This is the complete diagram for a DOL starter of a three-phase induction motor. This R, Y, B, these are the three bus bars. And this is the neutral bus bar. Now, from the three bus bars, supply is coming through the main contacts of this conductor. And on these lines have been connected three bimetallic overload relays, and the supply comes to three-phase motor. Now, on this side, supply from R phase through a fuse, through the off push button and then to the on push button and then to the contact of the thermal overload relay, and the relay coil goes back to the neutral. Here the conductor is rated for 230 volts. That's why the conductor coil has been connected between the one of the lines and the neutral. Now, when the on push button is pressed, this contactor will get 230 volt supply and you will get energized. Its main contacts will close and the motor will run. Now, this is the auxiliary contact of this contactor, which is connected in parallel with the on push button. This will work as a hold on contact. That means power to this conductor coil will continue to be available even when the pressure on the on push button is released. Now these two circuits, that is the power circuit and the control circuit, can be drawn separately as has been shown here. This is the power circuit and the control circuit has been drawn in a straight line fashion. This is called the schematic representation of the control circuit. Here you will find the contactor coil C and its contact has been shown separately. Although this contact is on the armature of this contactor, this has been shown separately because it is easy to follow a diagram drawn like this. So for recognition of this contact, of this contactor, we have used the same letters, capital letters for the coil and corresponding small letters for the contacts. Now henceforth, when we design contactor control circuits, we will draw the schematic diagram first and then we will develop the total wiring diagram. We have fabricated a DOL starter for a three-phase induction motor on a board for you to see. This is the induction motor. It has three terminals. This is the on push button. This is the off push button. This is the contactor. This is the thermal overload relay. These are the cartridge fuses. Now when we press this push button, the contactor will get energized and thereby three-phase supply will be made available across the three terminals of the motor and motor will continue to run. Now let us see, I press this push button, release the pressure, the motor continues to rotate. Now if I press the off push button, the motor stops. Again on push button, the motor rotates. In case of overload, the overload relay will operate and open one contact which is connected in the control circuit. Now I'll show the operation of this thermal overload relay by opening this contact manually. Now I just open this contact, the control circuit breaks and the motor stops. Start the motor, stop the motor. Now you have seen a DOL starter controlled from one position, but in actual situation it may be necessary to control a motor from more than one positions. Such operation of a motor from remote positions is called remote control. We will examine how to design a remote control operation for a DOL starter. This is the schematic diagram for the control circuit of a DOL starter with remote control facilities. There are three on push buttons and there are three off push buttons. These push buttons have been placed at different places. Now if any of the on push buttons, either S1 or S2 or S3 is pressed, the contactor gets energized and the motor starts. To stop the motor, we can press any of the stop push buttons. The contactor coil gets de-energized and the motor stops. The hold on contact has been connected in parallel with the on push button. This is the thermal overload relay contact, which opens in case of overload. This coil gets de-energized and the motor stops. Now from this diagram you can see that the general principle for remote control design is that all the off push buttons are connected in series and all the on push buttons are connected in parallel. Let us see the working of a DOL starter with remote control facilities. This is the circuit for a DOL starter with remote control facilities. One set of push button is situated in front of the motor, and this set of push button is placed in the control room. The motor can be started by pressing any of these on push buttons and could be stopped by pressing any of these off push buttons. Now I start this push button, the motor starts rotating. To switch off this motor, I press any of these push buttons. Motor stops. This can be started by pressing this push button and could be stopped by pressing any of these push buttons. In this film, you have seen a DOL starter. In the second part of this film, we will describe some more circuits like reversing starter, star delta starter, etc.